पिछली क्लास में हमने क्या किया था, डी ब्लॉक एलिमेंट्स। अब जब हम लोग एन ब्लॉक एलिमेंट्स करते हैं और डी ब्लॉक एलिमेंट्स करते हैं तो दोनों की कैरेक्टरिस्टिक्स बहुत हद तक सेम है। जैसे फॉर एग्जांपल हमने डी ब्लॉक में किया, अगर डी ब्लॉक कलर शो करता है या डी ब्लॉक कॉम्प्लेक्सेस बनाता है या डी ब्लॉक क्या कहते हैं उसको मेटल के जो कॉम्प्लेक्सेस है वो बनाएगा। सो इन अ सिमिलर मैनर जो एफ ब्लॉक है that is also going to show almost the same characteristics, right? Now when we talking of F block, तो F block में हमारे पास दो series के बारे में हम लोग पढ़ेंगे। One which is known as the 4F series. In F block, the elements में जो electrons हैं, they are going to be filled up in the F subshell. So F subshell में there are 7 orbitals, isn't it? तो 7 orbitals में कितने electrons आ सकते हैं? 14 electrons. 14 इलेक्ट्रॉन्स का मतलब ये हुआ कि द मैक्सिमम नंबर ऑफ एलिमेंट्स व्हिच आर प्रेजेंट इन ईच ऑफ द सीरीज दैट इज गोइंग टू बी 14। सो वी हैव टू एफ ब्लॉक सीरीज ओवर हियर, वन जिसमें वी आर गोइंग टू फिल अप 4F, राइट? सो वी हैव 14 एलिमेंट्स व्हिच आर प्रेजेंट इन दिस एंड द सेकंड वन दैट इज इन व्हिच वी आर गोइंग टू फिल अप 5F, सो देयर आर गोइंग टू बी 14 एलिमेंट्स व्हिच आर प्रेजेंट इन दिस आल्सो। नाउ 4F की जब हम फिलिंग अप शुरू करते हैं तो उसमें द फर्स्ट मेंबर दैट इज नोन एज लैंथेनम, as a result of which the entire series they are known as lanthanoid series. और जब हम लोग 5F fill करेंगे तो उसमें first member that is going to be actinium. Therefore उस series को हम लोग क्या बनाएंगे, that is known as actinoid series. Lanthanoid और actinoid also have a lot of similarities because of the same kind of electronic configuration which is going to take place in both. ठीक है? So let's study little bit about this. Now when we talking of F elements, as I just told you that in this the last electron or the differentiating electron, enters the F subshell. When we're looking at the general electronic configuration, that is going to be N minus 2 F 1 to 14, right? N minus 1 D 0 to 1, okay? And NS2. इसकी जो electronic configuration हम लोग देखेंगे दोनों series में, they do not have a definite pattern of arrangement. That is because of the reason that N minus 2 F and N minus 1 D they have the almost the same comparable energies. So the electrons they can easily jump from this to this or this to this. So they do not have a very set pattern of electronic configuration that we will see later. Now these elements they are known as inner transition elements. Why they are known as inner transition elements? The reason behind this is कि जब हम लोग n minus 2 f भरते हैं तो n minus 2 में हम लोग 4 भर रहे हैं, 4f. 4f का मतलब हम यहाँ पे 5d भर रहे हैं. तो जब हम 5d सीरीज भरनी शुरू करेंगे उससे पहले हम 14 ये भरते हैं. उसी तरह से जब हम लोग 6d भरनी शुरू करेंगे, we already started this, तो उससे पहले हम लोग 5f भरते हैं. So before filling the d, 5d सीरीज एंड 6d सीरीज, we first fill up the f block. That is how the name inner comes, right? When you were looking at the 5d सीरीज, तो आपने देखा था कि लैंथेनम से लेके हैफनियम तक पहले हम लोग 5d सीरीज में वी फिल अप ऑल द एफ ब्लॉक एंड देन फ्रॉम हैफनियम हेंसफोर्थ वी स्टार्ट फिलिंग अप द 5d सीरीज. ठीक है? सिमिलरली फ्रॉम एक्टिनियम टू व्हेन यू आर टॉकिंग ऑफ लॉरेंसियम, सो एक्टिनियम से लॉरेंसियम हम पहले क्या कहते हैं उसको यहां पे 5f भरते हैं, राइट? उसके बाद हम 6d सीरीज जो है दैट वी आर गोइंग टू स्टार्ट. इज इट क्लियर? सो दिस इज व्हाट दैट इज द रीजन व्हाई दे आर नोन एज inner transition element. So we are studying two series over here. One which is 4F, which is known as lanthanoids, and the other one which is 5F, which is known as actinoids after the name of the first elements. The first element in this case that is lanthanum, and the first element in this case that is going to be actinium. So let's go on to lanthanoids first. When we talking of lanthanoids, you already know, जब हम periodic table में देखते हैं, तो in case of the periodic tables, these series they are kept below the periodic table in separate compartment. They are not included in the main periodic table. So when we talking of lanthanoid series, the lanthanoids में हम लोग शुरू करते हैं भरना 4F, as I have already told you, the first member that is equal to lanthanum with atomic number which is equal to 57, ठीक है? और फिर उसके बाद हम लोग 14 elements यहाँ पे भरेंगे in these series from cerium to lutetium. So cerium is 58. To lutetium, which has an atomic number of 71. So we have 13 of these and 58 or ye ho gaya, that is going to be 14 elements which are going to be present over here. Now they occur very rarely in the Earth's crust, so they are given another name. They are also known as rare earth metals. Okay? Because बहुत ही rare होते हैं, therefore they are also known as rare earth metals. Let's go on to the general characteristics of lanthanoids. When we looking at the general characteristics, the first one which we are going to discuss over here is electronic configuration. So let's get familiar with the members of this group first and their symbols. So सबसे पहले हमारे पास आता है lanthanum with a symbol of La, with an atomic number of 57, ठीक है? उसके बाद आ गया cerium with a symbol Ce, उसके बाद praseodymium with a symbol of Pr, ठीक है? फिर उसके बाद आएगा नियोडियम विद अ सिंबल ऑफ Nd. फिर उसके बाद आता है प्रोमीथियम प्रोमीथियम विद अ सिंबल ऑफ Pm. देन वी हैव समेरियम with the symbol of Sm. Samarium ke baad we have europium with the symbol of Eu. Europium ke baad we have gadolinium with the symbol of Gd. And then we have terbium with the symbol of Tb. Terbium ke baad we have dysprosium dysprosium with the symbol of Dy dysprosium with the symbol of Dy. And then we have holmium with the symbol of HO. होलमियम के बाद हमारे पास आता है अर्बियम अर्बियम विद अ सिंबल ऑफ ER. एंड देन वी हैव थ्यूलियम विद अ सिंबल ऑफ TM, राइट? एंड आफ्टर दैट वी हैव यट्रियम with the symbol of Yb. And last is lutetium with the symbol of Lu. Now when we are filling the subshell 4F over here, the nearest noble gas that is going to be xenon. So when we are looking at the electronic configuration of lanthanum, it is going to be xenon 5d1 6s2. So in this case, you can see that 4F that is going to be equal to 0. There is no electron which is present in 4F in case of lanthanum. ठीक है? Cerium पे फिर हम जाते हैं. Xenon 4F1 5d1 6s2, राइट। फिर उसके बाद नेक्स्ट हमारे पास आ गया प्रेसिडियम व्हिच हैज ज़ीनॉन 4f3 5d0 6s2, सो देयर इज नो कनेक्शन बिटवीन द इलेक्ट्रॉनिक कॉन्फ़िगरेशंस इन दिस केस। ओके, फिर उसके बाद हमारे पास आता है नियोडिमियम व्हिच हैज अगेन ज़ीनॉन 4f4 5d0 6s2। Then we have promethium. Promethium it is again xenon 4f5 5d0 6s2. ठीक है, फिर उसके बाद हमारे पास आता है समेरियम. समेरियम has xenon 4f6 5d0 6s2. And then after that we come to europium. Europium has xenon 4f7 5d0 6s2. ठीक है, फिर उसके बाद आ गया गैंडोलियम. गैंडोलिनियम, गैंडोलिनियम का जो है दैट इज अगेन नो कनेक्शन 4f7 5d1 6s2. ओके, फिर गैंडोलिनियम के बाद वी हैव टर्बियम. अगेन टर्बियम इलेक्ट्रॉनिक कॉन्फ़िगरेशन चेंजेस टू 4f9 5d0 6s2. सो दिस विल ओनली कम विद प्रैक्टिस, यू विल हैव टू लर्न. देन वी हैव डिस्प्रोसियम. डिस्प्रोसियम अगेन हैज ज़ीनॉन 4f10 5d0 6s2. देन आफ्टर डिस्प्रोसियम वी हैव होल्मियम. होल्मियम इज गोइंग टू हैव 4f11. So, xenon 4f11 5d0 6s2. ठीक है, फिर उसके बाद आ गया हमारे पास अर्बियम. अर्बियम विल हैव xenon 4f12 5d0 6s2. ठीक है, और फिर उसके बाद हमारे पास आ जाता है थूलियम व्हिच इज गोइंग टू हैव 4f13. So we have xenon 4f13 5d0 6s2. And finally the last two in which there is going to be 4f14 in both the cases. So we have over here xenon 4f14 5d0 6s2 and xenon 4f14 5d1 6s2. राइट, सो दीज आर द मेंबर्स ओवर हियर. ऑल्दो आपको इसकी इलेक्ट्रॉनिक कॉन्फ़िगरेशंस जनरली यू डू नॉट गेट, बट स्टिल टू हैव एन आइडिया यू नीड टू नो द मेंबर्स ऑफ द लैंथेनॉइड सीरीज. सो दिस इज द फर्स्ट कैरेक्टरिस्टिक्स. एज आई हैव ऑलरेडी टोल्ड यू दैट द एनर्जीज ऑफ द डी ब्लॉक ओवर हियर, दैट द डी सबशेल 5d एंड 4f, द एनर्जीज दे आर कंपेरेबल. दैट इज द रीजन ऑफ you can say irregular electronic configuration over here, because electrons they keep jumping from 4f to 5d and vice versa. ठीक है, so इस करके यहाँ पे हमारे पास कुछ भी एक proper proper electronic configurations, जैसे हम लोग p block की करते हैं या d block की करी, उस तरह से electronic configurations हम लोग इसमें नहीं कर सकते, right? So they have all different kind of electronic configurations without any rules and regulations. Then we come to the second characteristics, which is going to be the oxidation states. The second characteristics which we are going to discuss, that is oxidation states. From this section, you might get certain reasoning or conceptual questions. So let's discuss all of them one by one. When we're looking at the oxidation states, the entire lanthanoids may jo sabse common oxidation state hai, that is going to be +3. Right? This is the most common oxidation, stable oxidation state, which is +3. But there are certain exceptions. For example, cerium and terbium. In this case, they show +4 oxidation state. This is due to their electronic configurations, because of when we're talking of cerium. So cerium ki jab humne electronic configuration dekhi thi, that was xenon 4f1 5d1
6s2, right? So if it loses 4 electrons, 2, 3 or 4, iski jo electronic configuration aa jayegi in the 4 positive oxidation state, that will be equal to the nearest noble gas configuration, which is going to be stable. So that is the reason cerium prefers forming plus 4 oxidation state rather than plus 3 oxidation state. In a similar manner, when we are going to terbium, when you look at the electronic configuration of terbium, it is going to be xenon 4F9 5D0 6S2. ठीक है? So जब terbium की 4 positive oxidation state आ जाती है, that is going to be xenon 4F7. So 4F7 over here, this is going to be half filled because F can accommodate 14 electrons. Therefore, ये half filled हो गया. That is the reason why it is again a stable configuration. You know that half filled, fully filled, they are going to be stable. Over here it is nearing the noble gas configuration, therefore it is stable. So cerium and terbium, they prefer forming 4 positive oxidation states rather than plus 3 oxidation states, which are going to be common in this case. Okay? Second anomalous behavior that is going to be shown by europium, ytterbium, europium and ytterbium. These both, they prefer showing plus 2 oxidation states. Okay, so why this is happening? Again, when you go to the electronic configuration of europium, in case of europium, the electronic configuration is xenon 4F7 5D0 6S2. Isn't it? So, jab aap europium in the 2 positive oxidation state, it will have half filled 4F7. That is the reason why it shows plus 2 oxidation state in order to attain a stable configuration of half filled F. In a similar manner, when we are going to ytterbium, in case of ytterbium, the electronic configuration that is going to be xenon 4F14 5D0 6S2. So when we are looking at the electronic configuration in 2 positive state, the electronic configuration that becomes xenon 4F14. Isn't it? So here bhi kya ho gaya? Fully filled electronic configuration, or fully filled electronic configuration ki wajah se the plus 2 oxidation state, that is going to be stable. Right? Whereas the rest of them, like we have lanthanum, we have lutetium and we have gadolinium, these three are going to exhibit only plus 3. Lanthanum, lutetium and gadolinium, all of these, they will show only plus 3 oxidation state. That is because of empty in case of lanthanum, half filled in case of gadolinium, and fully filled F block or F subshell in case of lutetium. Lanthanum will have 4F0, lutetium will have 4F14, and gadolinium will have 4F7 by losing 3 electrons. Therefore, they show plus 3 oxidation state. Right? Then we come to certain reasoning questions which you can say in this, or you can say there are certain conceptual questions which can be understood again on the basis of their electronic configurations only. The first one is that Eu2 positive acts as a strong reducing agent. Okay? Eu2 positive, it is going to behave as a strong reducing agent. Why? Because it has a tendency to accept 1 electron and go to Eu3 positive state. Lose 1 electron to go to Eu3 positive state. So it is going to behave as a, it's getting oxidized, so it will behave as a good reducing agent. Then secondly, when we're talking of certain other members of this family, like we have promethium, neodymium, right? And then we have terbium and dysprosium. Terbium and dysprosium, all of these, they are going to show plus 4 oxidation state. But this plus 4 oxidation state is only stable in case of oxides due to high electronegativity of oxygen. Otherwise, the more stable oxidation state in this case, that is going to be plus 3. Okay? Then we have another one, that yttrium in the 2 positive oxidation state, that is YB2 positive, has a configuration of 4F14. Right? So this is going to be acting as a reductant. Okay, so all these, they are explained on the basis of their electronic configurations. So this is the oxidation state. The third property which we are going to do, that is ionization enthalpy. The third property which we are going to do, that is ionization energies, ionization enthalpies. Now first, ionization enthalpies, that is of these, all these lanthanoids, IE1, that is of the order of 600 kilojoules, right, which is almost similar to the alkaline earth metals. Okay, but the second ionization energy, that is going to increase and it becomes almost double of the order of 1200 kilojoules. Okay, because we already know that the second ionization energies, they are going to be always higher. But the difference between these is going to be less, because when we take the electron from this, it will be released from 6s. So 6s se ek nikal gaya, fir uske baad 6s se jab dusra nikalna hai, so it is easier to remove it. Although the second ionization energy will always be higher because of increase in effective nuclear charge. Okay, fir uske baad the third ionization energy, that is going to be quite less, because the third electron now comes from either 5d or from 4f, isn't it? So third ionization energy kyun kam hogi? Because ek ya do ya teen ya char electrons usme present hai, to unme se humko nikalna jo hai, that is going to be easy. 5d will only have 0 or 1 or maximum of 2, but we've seen in the electronic configuration that 5d has either 0 or 1 electronic configuration, so to remove that, that is going to be easy. So the third ionization energy in this case, that is going to be less. Then the fourth characteristic which we are going to discuss is color. So it is the same as we've done in D block. They all are colored compounds or ions in solutions due to FF transitions. Same as in the case of DD transitions, they're going to be FF transitions over here. But all those having electronic configuration of F0 and F14, they are going to be colorless. The reason being same, right? Like for example, if we are taking Na3 positive, that is going to be colorless, because it has an electronic configuration of 4F0. Similarly, when we are going to lutetium-3 positive, that is also going to be colorless because of electronic configuration of 4F14. So there are no, you can say, there is going to be no, in this case there is no electron present for transitions, in this case there is no orbital present for transition, therefore they do not show any color. Right? So reason of color is same, that when they are traveling to a high energy, they are absorbing light, and once they come back to the ground state, they are going to emit those radiations in the visible region. So if they are absorbing high energy, they are going to fall in the lower energy region. If they are taking in lower energy, they are going to fall in the higher energy region. Jo humne wo color field kiya tha,
In case of D block, the same is applicable over here. Is it clear? Then we come to the magnetic properties. The fifth characteristic which we are going to discuss, that is the magnetic properties. Now over here, again, they may be diamagnetic. Diamagnetic means they are going to be repelled by the magnetic field, right? Diamagnetic is due to paired electrons, okay? Or they may be paramagnetic, which means they are going to be attracted by the magnetic field. So they are going to be unpaired electrons which are present in this case, right? So the magnetic properties are due to this. Ions which are going to contain paired electrons, they are going to be diamagnetic, and all those which are going to have unpaired electrons, they are going to be paramagnetic in nature, right? And then we come to the sixth property, which is chemical reactivity. In case of chemical reactivity, we say that all the lanthanoids, they are highly electropositive. So they are all going to behave as metals because of their low ionization energies. ठीक है? और यहाँ पे they almost have the similar reactivity. The similar reactivity that is attributed to the fact that the electrons, they are going to enter into the same 4F subshell. There are 14 electrons which are going to enter into the same 4F subshell. As a result of which, because the electrons are in the same subshell, they have almost same reactivities. Okay? There's not going to be much of a difference. Now, because of their similar reactivities, it becomes very difficult to separate the metals of F block, because they have same reactivity, so segregation in this case, that is not going to be possible, right? So they are lanthanides. In general, it is seen that they are more reactive than D block. They are going to be more reactive than D block elements. Okay, so just let's go on to the chemical characteristics of 4F series. When we're looking at the chemical characteristics, we see that number one, all of these, they are going to be soft metals. Okay, and because of their high reactivity, they have a tendency to tarnish. Tarnish means they become blackish on exposure to air. On exposure to air. Okay? Now over here, it is only yttrium which does not get tarnished. Does not tarnish due to formation of a protective, due to formation of a protective oxide film on its surface. Right? So there's a protective layer of oxide on its surface. That is the reason why when it is exposed to air, it does not become black. Rest all of them, they are going to tarnish or they are going to become black. Okay? Now, as we have done in D block, the hardness depended upon the number of unpaired electrons which were present. In this similar manner, over here also, hardness of metals, that is going to increase due to increase in number of unpaired electrons. because the metallic bonding that increases with increase in number of unpaired electrons, therefore as the atomic number is going to increase, the hardness that will also keep on increasing till the middle of the series, and after that once pairing starts place, the hardness again that starts decreasing. ठीक है, so जब आप lanthanum से जाते रहोगे, till we fill 7 electrons, the hardness will keep on increasing. फिर 7 unpaired के बाद एक electron fill किया, तो there is going to be 6 unpaired, then 5 unpaired, 4 unpaired, so that way lutetium that is going to be very very soft, right? फिर उसके बाद हमारे पास जो next आता है, they all have metallic structure, they may have BCC, they may have FCC, they may have simple cubic, so they are going to all have metallic structure, and all of them they are good conductors of okay, they are going to be good conductors of heat and electricity. The reactivity will keep on decreasing with increase in atomic number because of decrease in number of unpaired electrons. Okay? So reactivity decreases with increase in number of unpaired electrons. Okay? Then we have the next solubility of compounds, that is going to be our next characteristic. The fifth one which we have is solubility of compounds. Now when we are looking at the compounds of this, it is seen that this is very very important for you, fluorides of 4F series, ठीक है, then oxides, hydroxides, this is an important question for competitions, hydroxides, carbonates, phosphates, chromates, right? And oxalates, they are insoluble in water. All of these, they are going to be insoluble in water. Okay? So salts of fluorides, oxides, hydroxides, carbonates, phosphates, chromates and oxalates, they are going to be insoluble. Whereas halides other than fluorides, that is we have chlorides, bromides and iodides. So all the other halides, they are soluble, right? And apart from this, we have nitrates, acetates, perchlorates, okay? और फिर उसके बाद वी हैव सॉल्ट्स ऑफ ऑक्सा एसिड्स, सॉल्ट्स ऑफ ऑक्सा एसिड्स, दे आर गोइंग टू बी सॉल्युबल इन वाटर. गॉट इट? देन वी कम टू बेसिक कैरेक्टर ऑफ ऑक्साइड्स. बेसिक कैरेक्टर ऑफ हाइड्रोक्साइड, सॉरी नॉट ऑक्साइड्स, बेसिक कैरेक्टर ऑफ hydroxides. Now when we are doing the basic character of hydroxides, in this case all the lanthanoids, they are going to form hydroxides of the type LnOH3 in the plus 3 oxidation state. Okay? And all of these, they are going to be ionic in nature, they are going to be basic in nature, right? They are going to be stronger bases, stronger bases than
एयर है OH एल्यूमिनियम हाइड्रोक्साइड, दे आर स्ट्रॉन्गर बेसिस देन एल्यूमिनियम हाइड्रोक्साइड बट वीकर देन कैल्शियम हाइड्रोक्साइड, वीकर देन कैल्शियम हाइड्रोक्साइड. ठीक है, फिर उसके बाद वी से दैट एज द आयनिक साइज डिक्रीजेस फ्रॉम लैंथेनम टू ल्यूटीटियम the basicity will also decrease because we are going in a series. So in a series the size that is going to decrease. So as the size decreases the basic character decreases. The basic character is also going to decrease. That is because of strong bonding between the metal and the hydroxide. That OH negative is not easily released, therefore the basic character that will decrease. Okay, so it means that when we talking of the hydroxides over here, lanthanum hydroxide, that is the most basic, and lutetium hydroxide, that is going to be the least basic. ठीक है, have you understood? So this is what basic character is. Then we come to atomic or ionic radii of lanthanoid series. Atomic and ionic radii. All the lanthanoids, when we talking of, in this case with increasing atomic number, what is going to happen? We are going along the series. So with increasing atomic number, the atomic radii decreases. Because the nuclear charge that will keep on increasing and we are filling up the electron in the same subshell, so effective nuclear charge will also increase, therefore the size that will keep on decreasing when we are traveling from lanthanum to lutetium. But the decrease is going to be very very small, that is because of what? Because of the electron entering in the same subshell. Okay, now over here the steady decrease can be explained on the basis of lanthanoid contraction although the decrease as I just said is very very small. Now what is lanthanoid contraction over here? We are filling up all the electrons in 4f. Okay, so agar hum sare ke sare 4f mein hi bharte jayenge, so what is going to happen? The nuclear charge that is increasing by 1 unit, right? And because of that, the effective nuclear charge, due to the poor shielding effect of 4F, the effective nuclear charge does not increase to a very great extent. So we know that F block that has poor shielding effect. So us poor shielding effect ki wajah se, what is going to happen? Lanthanoid contraction that is going to take place. So let's understand what is the cause of lanthanoid contraction. So what is happening? As we are moving along the series, nuclear charge increases. Nuclear charge that will keep on increasing, okay, by 1 unit, and the electron that is entering the same subshell. So as a result, what is going to happen is the nuclear charge is increasing. Number one, number two, electron enters the same subshell, that is 4f. Isn't it? So 4f में ही वो add हो रहा है. So because of increasing atomic number and nuclear charge, the effective nuclear charge should also increase. But due to the poor shielding effect of f block, the outermost electrons they are or the outermost shells they are going to be more strongly attracted by the nucleus because of poor shielding effect. So as a result, the is two facts which are taking place, that is increase in nuclear charge and poor shielding effect of F block. There is going to be a decrease in atomic size, but the decrease that is not going to be very large. थोड़ी decrease जो है a few picometers that will keep on taking place along the series. This is what lanthanoid contraction is. ठीक है, what are going to be the consequences of lanthanoid contraction? So when we talking of consequences of lanthanoid contraction, we've already done this in D block. So this is again a conceptual question which can come to you. The first one is resemblance of second and third transition series. We've already done this. There is going to be resemblance in size of the second and third transition series. Second transition series is that we are going to fill up 4D, and third transition series we are going to fill up 5D, right? So जब हम लोग second transition series यहाँ पे भर रहे हैं, तो as a result of which first we are going to fill up the F block 4F, isn't it? जब हम यहाँ पे 4D भरते हैं और 4D के बाद this is second transition series means we are filling up 4D over here. Third transition series means we are filling up 5D over here. So 5D भरने से पहले हम लोगों ने 4F भरना है. 4F अब हम भरेंगे तो lanthanoid contraction होगा. Lanthanoid contraction होगा, so as a result of that, the second and the third transition series it is going to have the same sizes. Example which we had done was that of hafnium and zirconium in the D block. Hafnium and zirconium, they have the same size. That is because of lanthanoid contraction, because of filling up of 4F before filling 5D. ठीक है? So this is one consequence. Then the second consequence over here is resemblance in properties of lanthanoid metals. Resemblance in properties of lanthanoid metals. That is again due to very small change in ionic radii, that there is going to be similar properties of all the lanthanoid elements starting from where? Starting from lanthanum to lutetium. ठीक है? And thirdly, because of lanthanoid contraction, it becomes very difficult to separate the elements of F block, right? So it becomes a little difficult to separate the elements of F block. Again, the reason behind it is the same, that they have almost the same sizes and the same, you can say, क्या कहते हैं उसको, similarity in properties, that we cannot separate the F block elements. ठीक है, clear हो गया? So this is what lanthanide contraction causes and consequences. Lastly, we will go on to the uses of F for of lanthanoids. Okay, so what are the uses? The most important use is that these are important components of mesh metals. What are mesh metals? Mesh metals, they are metals of lanthanoids with other metals. For example, iron, lanthanoid metal, iron, and then traces of sulfur, carbon, calcium, aluminium, etc. So these are what mesh metals are. Lanthanoid elements with iron, and then there are traces of sulfur, carbon, calcium and aluminium. For example, if you're talking of one metal or one alloy of lanthanoids in which there is the lanthanoid which is present is cerium. Cerium consists of 30 to 50% of this alloy, which is used in scavenging oxygen and sulfur. scavenging oxygen and sulfur from other metals. So separation of oxygen and sulfur from other metals. For that, this mesh metal which is used in with cerium, that is present from 30 to 50%. ठीक है? फिर उसके बाद next is कि if we are adding around 3% of mesh metal to magnesium, it increases the strength of this alloy. It increases the strength of this alloy and it is used in making jet engine parts. Jet aeroplanes होते हैं, उसके engine parts को बनाने में काम आता है. Fighter planes, which are known as. ठीक है? फिर उसके बाद cerium and magnesium alloys. Cerium and magnesium alloys, they are used in flashlight powders. They are used in flashlight powders. And these days, lanthanoids, they are also extensively used in lasers. Okay? So this is all about lanthanoids, which we will do today. Actinoids, they also have almost the same properties as lanthanoids. It's a very small topic of 10 minutes, 10 to 15 minutes, that which we will finish in our next class. Okay?